Hello, here I am going to explain some basics of gas chromatography. Gas chromatography is an analytical technique employed for separating components based primarily on their volatilities. Gas chromatography offers both qualitative and quantitative information for individual components present in the sample mixture. So here, this gas chromatography is a technique used for the separation of volatile substances or substances that can be made volatile from one another in a mixture at high temperatures. So here you can see that in this picture, it's a picture of a gas chromatographic unit here in the right side. It's a gas chromatographic unit. This gas chromatographic involves a sample being injected and vaporized onto the head of the chromatographic column. The sample is transported through the column, that is stationary phase, by a carrier gas. Generally, there are two types of gas chromatographic techniques or GC techniques. Gas solid chromatography or GSC, gas liquid chromatography or GLC. Here in gas solid chromatography or GSC, stationary phase is an inert solid and mobile phase is a gas. Gas liquid chromatography or GLC, stationary phase is a liquid retained on the surface of an inert solid support. Mobile phase is a gas. Basic principle of gas chromatography is that sample is vaporized by injection into a heated system. After this, the samples are eluted through a column by inert gaseous mobile phase, and the components are detected. In gas solid chromatography or GSC, principle of separation is adsorption. It is used infrequently because limited number of stationary phases and increased resolution time. Generally, this GSC is used for the separation of simple gases like methane, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, etc. In gas liquid chromatography or GLC, the principle of separation is partition. Component more soluble in stationary phase travels slower through this chromatographic column. Then component less soluble in stationary phase travels faster through chromatographic column. That is, components are separated according to their partition coefficient. So in gas solid chromatography, the principle is adsorption, and gas liquid chromatography, the principle is partition. Gas liquid chromatography, the principle is partition. In application level, GLC is more important. So this GLC or gas liquid chromatography commonly referred to as gas chromatography. The more important at application level is GLC, which is therefore often simply referred to as gas chromatography. In GLC, the mobile phase is a gas. It is also known as a carrier gas. that carrier gas or mobile gas should be chemically inert, should be cheap and readily available, it should be high quality, and it should be suitable for the detector also. Generally, we use inert gases such as helium, argon, nitrogen, etc. The stationary phase in GLC is a non-volatile liquid like methyl silicone or polyethylene glycol held on inert porous solid. The stationary phase colons are two types. One is packed colon, the other one is capillary colon or open tubular colon. In packed colon, contain finely divided inert solid material. Generally, it is diatomaceous earth, a spongy type earthy material, coated with thin layer of non-volatile liquid as stationary phase. Most packed colons are 1.5 to 10 meter in length and around 2 to 6 millimeter internal diameter. Here in the right side, you can see a picture that represents a packed colon. Here this brown ring is denoted as the outer surface of colon. Here inside this colon, finely divided innate solid materials are there. Then this solid materials are coated with thin layer of non-volatile liquid. This is a packed colon. So in the packed colon have a length around 1.5 to 10 meter in length and internal diameter around 2 to 6 mm internal diameter. Next, capillary colons. It is also known as open tubular colon or OT colon. The capillary colons have length around 10 to 100 meter and it has an internal diameter 0.1 to 0.5 millimeter. There are two types of capillary colons. One is wall coated open tubular colon. It is also known as WCOT. Second one, support coated open tubular colon. It is also known as SCOT. This wall coated open tubular colon or WCOT consists of a capillary tube, and inside walls are coated with liquid stationary phase. Here you can see in the picture, this black ring shows the outer surface of capillary tube, and the inside walls are coated with thin film of liquid, or that behaves as or that act as a stationary phase. So this is the WCOT or wall coated open tubular colon. In SCOT, the inner wall of the capillary is lined with a thin layer solid support material onto which the liquid has been fixed, or liquid phase or the stationary phase has been fixed. Here you can see that the black ring represents the outer surface of capillary colon and the brown ring, which is inside in the capillary colon, it is a thin layer solid support material onto which the thin film of liquid has been fixed. So this liquid behaves as a stationary phase. So in wall coated open tubular colon, consists of a capillary tube inside, and the inside walls are coated with liquid stationary phase. in support coated open tubular colon or SCOT. The inner walls of the capillary is lined with a thin layer solid support, in this picture is brown color, on to which the liquid phase or the liquid stationary phase has been fixed. Next, instrumentation and flow diagram of GLC, gas liquid chromatography. A schematic representation of the basic components of a GLC instrument is shown in this picture. Here, a carrier gas cylinder is fitted with a pressure controller or pressure regulator to control the pressure of mobile gas, and a pressure gauge that indicates the pressure of gas which is passed to this tube. A flow controller to ensure a constant rate of flow of mobile phase into the colon. Here a sampling unit or injection unit. Sampling unit or injection unit is attached to the colon head. Since the sample should be in vaporized state, the injection unit is provided with a thermostat that helps to maintain the desired temperature above the boiling point of samples. Gaseous samples may be introduced by a gas tight hypodermic needle. For liquid sample, syringes may be used. The colon is the most integral part of the system where the basic chromatographic process takes place. It consists of coiled tubing made of heat resistant materials like stainless steel, modified gas, fused silica, etc. The desired temperature can be maintained or can be set by using this thermostat. Then each component comes out from the colon is immediately detected by this detector, and this detector is connected to a flow meter which measures the flow of components, and this detector is then connected to an amplifier, then amplifier is connected to recorder. The detector produced electric signals proportional to the concentration of components and number of components. The signals are amplified by this amplifier and it is recorded as peaks at intervals on the chromatograph. The colon is maintained at a constant temperature higher than the boiling point of least volatile component in the sample mixture, with help for the help of this thermostat. The sample injection port or injection unit and the detector unit are usually maintained at still higher temperatures to promote rapid vaporization of the injected sample and to prevent condensation in the detector. As soon as the emergence of each component from the colon is detected, and the detector response is sent to a recorder recurrence, already discussed, already told. The resulting graph is the resulting graphical chart consists of separate peaks corresponding to different components that can be very useful in qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. So these are the things which are already told in previous slide. That is, the carrier gas is supplied into the apparatus from a pressurized cylinder. The gas passes through a two-stage pressure regulator and flow controller to control its flow rate. A small amount of the sample is injected by means of a syringe into a heated chamber. In this chamber, the sample is injected. If it is a liquid, then it will be converted to gas and it is carried on to the colon by the carrier gas. Colons are made of heat resistant materials like stainless steel, fused silica and modified glass. As the mobile phase carries vaporized sample through the colon, separation of components occurs due to their differential partitioning and equilibrium between stationary liquid phase and carrier gas. Components differentially retained in the stationary phase reach the colon outlet at different times. Each component that comes out from the colon is detected by the detector and is recorded by a recorder. Generally, two types of detectors are mainly used, that is thermal conductivity detector and frame ionization detector. So these are the things which happened in a gas chromatography unit. Then here is a picture which shows that certain peaks and some separations in this coil. Here suppose the mixture contains four components. One is denoted as green, second one is yellow, third one is black, and fourth one is red. That components that passes through this colon, the first component that emerges from this colon is green. So that signal is first recorded like this. Then second component is emerges from yellow, and that component is recorded like this. So, and the third component, black and this red is very close to this retention time or the time taken to travel through this detector is very close. So, this peak like this. So, this is a separations. It's a model of separations that happened in gas chromatography column. Here, another important term, retention time or RT. Retention time or RT is a measure of the time taken for a component to pass through a chromatographic column. It is calculated as the time for injection to detection. It's very good, very important parameter, that is retention time. Retention time is a measure of the time taken for a component to pass through a chromatographic colon. It is calculated as the time from injection to detection. Here, a graphical chart consisting of a separate peaks corresponding to different components can be very useful in qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis, because the number of peaks correlates with the number of components in the sample. The area under the each peak correlates the relative concentration of the component. If the standard information is available, the retention time under different conditions can be used to identify each component. Here, a schematic of chromatographic peaks of chromatographic peaks for a sample consisting of two gases X and Y is shown in this picture. So three peaks are there, one for carrier gas and the other from one for component Y and one for component X. Here this is the retention time of the component Y. This is the retention time for component Y and this is the retention time for component X. Suppose we want to calculate the percentage of component. Percentage in a mixture is calculated by using by this equation, that is area under each peak and area under the component peak divided by total area into 100. Suppose you want to calculate the percentage of component X here, then using this equation, area under the component peak, thus this area divided by total area, that means the area under the sum of area under each component, that is total area. So percentage of component is equal to area under the component of peak divided by total area into 100. Then area under a peak, as a particular peak, can be calculated by using peak height into peak height, peak width, in the half of its height. That is the area under a specific peak. Percentage of component can be calculated by using this equation. Then next, applications of gas chromatography. First one, it is efficient separation technique. That is, gas chromatography is used to bring about the separation of components in complex organic, organometallic and biochemical systems. As the components are separated as vapors, each separated component can be collected from the exit end of the colon and condensed to yield the pure component. Then second one is in qualitative analysis. Under identical conditions of flow rate and temperature, the retention time for a given compound on a given colon will always be the same. Thus, retention times obtained from gas chromatograms allow identification of species by reference to standard retention time charts. Hence, the method of GLC can be used in qualitative analysis of mixtures of organic compounds such as natural products. Then next one, this GLC provides an excellent means of confirming the presence or absence of a component in a mixture of organic compounds. After recording the chromatogram of a particular mixture, certain component of a non-compound suspected to be present in the mixture is added to it, the gas chromatographic process is performed and another chromatogram is recorded. Then, if a new peak appears in the new chromatogram, it can be concluded that the particular compound added is not a component of the original mixture. If an enhancement of an existing peak occurs, it can be concluded that the component is there in the mixture. Then the third one, in quantitative analysis. Since peak areas in gas chromatograms are proportional to the concentration of the concerned components and thereby reveal quantitative information, gas chromatography is widely used as an analytical technique in petroleum industry, in petrochemical industry, biomedical analysis, manufacture of medicines, analysis of pollutants in air, etc. Then in preparative organic chemistry, and it is also used in combination with other chromatographic methods. So that is the superior fractionation qualities of GLC are often combined with NMR spectroscopy, IR spectroscopy, mass spectroscopy, electroanalytical techniques in various qualitative and quantitative analytical experiments. So here the element fractions from the gas chromatographic column are separately collected, and each fraction is then investigated by NMR, IR or mass spectroscopic, spectroscopic or electroanalytical techniques. Such applications have proved very useful for the analysis of many multi-component mixtures. So these are the main applications of gas chromatography. So these are all about gas chromatography, fundamentals of gas chromatography. Thank you.